That's perfect timing.
Yeah, that was damn perfect timing. I wasn't even planning that, but
good lord.
Let me go ahead and introduce the boys in blue for those of you who may not be familiar, which is, I'm sure there's one or two of you out there that may be wondering, hey, I don't really know much about Korean Dota, but who are all these white guys? This is Team Zephyr. They play and live in Korea, and for all sense and purposes, they are a Korean team. And they include Blitz, Sexy Bambo, Purge, Eosin, and Corey. They won the last season of the Korean Dota 2 League 3-0 over MVP Phoenix, but they're 1-1 this season, and their only loss is against MVP Phoenix.
Well, I mean, both teams have lost to MVP Phoenix 2-0 in kind of like the new style that MVP Phoenix has been playing lately, mm-hmm. with the kind of sustainability hero fighting team with lots of healing. And, yeah, great pushing power.
Yeah, I really like it, just their style of play. It seems really cool, and they're making it work.
Yeah. They've had some scrappy games, but, I mean, yeah, they haven't lost yet with it, so it's been a lot of fun. But I feel like both teams today, both Rave and Zephyr, are really looking to win, make a kind of like, I don't know, I wouldn't say make a statement, but they're kind of trying to get some retribution.
Yeah.
So trying to, like, bring it back, because they cannot lose this game, or they're just going to get way too behind in the standings, and it's going to look bad for this season here.
Now, the last time these two teams actually played an official match was back in Season 3 of the Nexon Sponsorship League. This was, I think, at least 4 months ago. Mm-hmm. It was before a single title was picked up by Zephyr in Korea. And back then, Rave was known as Eye of the Tiger, but overall, their roster is, for the most part, the same. They include Pyong, who's kind of their captain leader, and only Korean, ironically, as well. Mm. They also have a cast member called Cass. Sorry about that. I couldn't help myself. They also have Chrissy, Rior, and Jao. Jao, formerly of Evil Geniuses from back in the day. Ironically, Bambo as well. So we have two former EG members playing against each other. And Rave, so far, they lost against Pokerface, and they also lost against Phoenix. So looking to grab their first win in Tier 1. But if they don't beat Zephyr here and now, it may be hard for them to really grab an actual win in Tier 1.
Yeah, it's definitely seeming that way. And yeah, I'm very excited to see how Rave play. Rave kind of play like a very kind of standard kind of style. Nothing too crazy. They're not too out there. They just, I don't know, their mechanics and team fighting are just not up to par with MVP Phoenix and Zephyr in the past. So we'll have to wait and see what they can bring today.
Rave does favor kind of like a little bit of a push lineup. Mm. Like, they don't go all out with the push. Like, maybe they pick up the Lycan and make the Lycan like another kind of, I guess, push-centric hero, like an Invoker that goes for Forged Spirits. But it's almost never, like, full-on into that.
Yeah. So it's kind of more of a balanced lineup, not leaning towards too far either way. But maybe they have something planned for Zephyr. I mean, Zephyr obviously has a lot of exposure, a lot of games online, a lot of VODs to be studied. So
yes,
we'll have to wait and see what Rave can really bring to the table. And we did talk to Zephyr before, and they said they're going to play a bit more of a standard style. They weren't going to, nothing too crazy. They're just going to try and just play straight up.
Yeah. They didn't say, you know, anything crazy would be happening. No, you know, position one Warlock MVP Phoenix style kind of strategy. I think that after their last loss in the KDL and with TI qualifiers coming up, they really have to buckle down and just practice. There is no time for rest, no time for vacations.
Yeah, I feel like, yeah, definitely like kind of like a wake-up call for them at the right time. I mean,
yeah.
They have time to kind of regroup and get ready for the TI qualifiers and for the rest of this season, and definitely try and bring their A game.
Yeah, I believe they're coming around pretty darn soon. I think within a week or so.
Yeah,
they're
creeping
up. Qualifiers for the C/Korean region.
Yeah, well, we already have the American qualifiers going on right now. Like,
indeed, we do.
Yeah,
so many games, dude.
Way
so
too much.
Many.
Way too much Dota right now, guys.
Yeah.
I can't watch it all. I try.
No one actually can. That's the thing. Like. It doesn't matter how devoted of a fan you are. You just can't watch everything.
Yeah, it's brutal.
It's too hard, but at the same time, it generally means there's just a lot of Dota to watch. Oh. And finally
some fangirls with the KDL.
Finally, but that's the first time I've ever seen girls actually hide their face on camera
really?
At a Korean Dota tournament.
Oh, really? So mm-hmm. it's finally come to this.
It's gone full circle from the early days of Brood War to now.
This is great for the scene, no doubt.
It is. Isun won. Heisu. I don't know what that said. Sorry. They were talking about someone and they were doing something, but I couldn't catch much beyond that.
Fair enough. We'll have to keep working on that Korean.
I've been practicing a lot. I have been practicing.
Well, I haven't, and I'm sorry for that. But,
it's okay, man. You've been watching a lot of Dota.
I have been watching a lot of Dota, you know. Trying to get on top of things, but with these qualifiers out, it's getting too stressful, man.
All right. Well, I believe that... Where'd Bamboo head off to?
Maybe a last-minute toilet break?
Yeah. Oh, that's...
What was
you
that?
Guys could read that one.
I missed it.
It's like love sexy Bambo, cute sexy Bambo.
Oh.
So fangirl in the crowd, but maybe she's with her boyfriend. I am not sure.
Well, it wouldn't be a too happy boyfriend if that was the case. Oh, my goodness.
I'm sure it's all in good fun, Moonglade.
No. All right. We'll keep it on the level.
Well, as far as predictions go for the upcoming match, I do anticipate a Zephyr win.
I do, too.
I think that it could be a 2-1.
I'm going to say it's going to be a 2-0 for Zephyr, and I'm going to say Zephyr's going to show what they used to show.
Yeah.
I mean, after such a loss to Phoenix, so they can't be happy with where they are, and I'm sure for the last week they've really buckled down and definitely practiced a lot harder than what they're used to.
I've noticed against the Korean team, Zephyr will show you who is indestructible champion of the KDL.
I believe it.
I believe it as well.
I love that guy. He brings us Monster.
Yeah, he does. He's very nice. We have some cool fans here at the KDL.
Yeah, we got some chill fans, and I appreciate that.
Me too. Yeah, but I don't know. I just have this weird feeling that it may end up being 2-1, even though like half of me is thinking, oh, Zephyr's going to 2-0 Rave. I think Rave may kind of pull something weird out of their pocket and provide a 2-1.
Well, you know, Sexy Bamboo was looking rather tired.
He was.
Before the match, you know, this could come into play. He could be, I mean, he is... He had to run to the bathroom, so maybe he's not feeling the best right now. I mean, that's kind of uncharacteristic and really holding up the show. So you wouldn't want to do it unless you absolutely have to. So hey. I'm kind of thinking something's going on.
It's no different than the computer problems that happen every now and then.
I guess so.
Mm-hmm. All right, but don't worry. Bamboo's walking right past us into the booth, and he's good to go.
We'll have to see what happens in games, ladies and gentlemen. Look out for Sexy Bamboo. Is he going to be on top of his game?
I sure hope so.
I hope so, too. I really want to see some great games.
Yeah, I know he didn't get the most sleep last night.
Yeah, well, I mean, he's also suffering from these TI qualifiers. It's just too many games.
He's trying to watch them as well.
Yeah, I mean, that's a good sign. You know, a lot of research is important.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, who wants to miss the TI qualifiers as well?
I want to watch it all.
You see, like, the best and brightest teams, like, coming up. And, like, potential contenders of, like, maybe not this TI, but the next TI, some of these teams that make a splash may end up being your top teams. Like, you know, last year, you know, during, like, TI, we didn't even really, like, see much of Empire. Now, all of a sudden, they're, like, they're a top team in Europe. They got an invite directly into TI 4.
They're kicking ass, and absolutely, man. I agree completely.
Yeah, and interestingly, you know, we're seeing a lot of the... more consistent, you know, teams that have been around the corner for a long time, like Alliance, like Na'Vi, you know, they don't seem to be as dominant as they used to be.
They definitely had their heyday. I mean, they're not out of it by any shot, but
no, man.
They've lost power and others have gained power. And
no matter what happens, Na'Vi will still get second place.
Yeah, I'd say that's a pretty good chance. But no, you're absolutely right. A lot of teams have really come into their own, and this TI is going to be really interesting to see, but I got to say, DK is looking to be the team to beat in the main tournament.
Nah, they certainly are, Moonglade, and definitely a runner-up behind them would be EG.
They have been doing really well lately.
Evil Geniuses just look so good nowadays.
They've been really on fire. They've been a pleasure to watch, especially at Star Ladder.
I love watching them, man. I mean, I'm not even afraid to like say EG is like my favorite team to watch, and I love
Arteezy. Oh, wow.
Yeah, man. I'll say it live and proudly on stream. I don't care.
I'm a fan of DK, man. I bought their like their little emblem thing, so I get like items and stuff if they win, and they always win. So I get all that free loot, dude.
Do you have that, the DK Ice 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 set for the Invoker?
Not yet. I should actually look into that.
Yeah, it's pretty baller. Also, Ice has a new Timbersaw set it's in the Dota Marketplace, but I don't think it's been officially uploaded yet. But the set, the quality is so high, it'll definitely get in-game. It's only a matter of time. And
oh, wow.
Timbersaw being one of my favorite heroes of all time, I have to nab up that set. There's no way I'm going to let that fly.
No, I respect that. That's damn cool. I was never good at Timbersaw. Like, I've played a lot of Timbersaw. But man, something about him.
I have like 150 games of Timbersaw. Wow. The thing is, like, when I first played him, I was so bad at the hero. I was like ridiculously bad, and I lost like 10 games in a row, and I got frustrated. So I was thinking to myself, okay, Whiplash, you are going to learn this hero and become good at him. And I just kept playing him, and I got better. I really learned the ins and outs of the hero to a point where he became my strongest hero.
Wow. Yeah, I'd have to say he's my weakest hero, actually, in Dota. Like, that's how weak it is. Like,
I can give you some tips, Moonglade. Yeah. If there is one hero I can legitimately help a lot of people out with, it is the Timbersaw.
I just seem to can't hit trees with his chain, man. That's like my...
That's the hardest part.
That's my curse right there.
Yeah, I can... I've gotten pretty good with that skill. I have, like, you know, all the numbers memorized in my head. They're floating around up there, and I just pull them down the earth when I need them.
Yeah, yeah. I respect that. I mean, my favorite kind of... I've been actually practicing a lot of Invoker lately because he seems like one of the most interesting heroes with his like amazing amount of like
the
abilities.
Skill ceiling is really high.
Yeah,
on that hero.
He's very hard to play, and he's got so many different abilities. And
he's a lot of fun to play. Yeah. That's another hero that I played a lot of. Maybe about a year ago or so, I was really playing a lot of Quaz-Wex Invoker.
Yeah, I like Quaz-Exort, man. That's my style right there. I want to farm. I want to sunstrike people, and I want to get rich. And
I want to tornado and EMP people, and then cold snap them, and just like right click them to death.
Yeah, but that got nerfed, so it's not as fun anymore. I feel.
Yeah,
it's harder to
get
that EMP off. So
it is.
Yeah.
Apologies for the delays, ladies and gentlemen. I'm not exactly sure what's going on, but I guess that wasn't really on Bamboo's shoulders as far as the delays are concerned. But as I say that, it looks like we're getting ready to move into the match. So, Moonglade, you think it's going to be a 2-0? I think it's a 2-1. Those are our predictions. Let's move into the draft for the first game in this best of three. This is a Tier 1 match between Rave and Zephyr. The winner will get $5,000, approximately USD. Yep.
Both teams coming off a loss, so obviously no added funds to that win. But both teams definitely really needing a win right now.
Indeed. And as far as the bans are concerned, very quick bans coming out from Rave. They're saying, listen, Sand King, Aosin, you're not going to have control over this hero. And Mirana has had a ridiculous win rate and pick this patch. I think she's above 70%. It's ridiculous,
she's
man.
She's amazing. She's amazing.
You can't let her go through the bans.
Unless you're picking her, yeah, you get a ban.
Yeah, exactly. But Zephyr decide to, they get rid of the Invoker. Very standard. No surprises there. Mm. He's just such a powerful hero. Yeah. And Batrider as well. Again, probably, he is the best initiator in the game.
Oh, easily, for sure. I mean, Lasu was ridiculous. I mean, even after the nerf, he's still such a great hero. And heavily picked still, so.
Indeed.
Yeah, safe ban there. Mm-hmm.
And
sure.
Just really good in 1v1 scenarios as well. Mm. But most of the time you end up against a tri-lane, but the hero is just very good at surviving with Fireflight, so you can get your farm where you need it. But we'll have to wait and see what Rave wants to grab for their first hero. They have first pick, but Zephyr, they get to grab two heroes in a row because they got that second pick. They will be on the Radiant side compared to Rave on the Dire. And it's just kind of wait and see. But Rave, they love Lycan, so if they want to grab him early on, I wouldn't be entirely surprised, but they get the Centaur. And Zephyr, very quick double picks on both the Ancient Apparition as well as the Wraith King. And we'll have to wait and see how they want to play and position the Wraith King. But
we got a Naga.
We do have the Naga. This is definitely a J.O. hero. He loves to play the Naga. One of the teams that they like to put him in the safe lane compared to the mid, it's... I feel more of a stylistic preference as far as the hero is concerned, but I do like to play him a little bit more in the mid lane personally, but still definitely a J.O. pickup.
Yeah, it's very interesting. I guess the safe lane, I mean, you get better farm, you're going to less chance of getting ganked, and safer early game. So if you give Naga that kind of advantage early, that kind of head start, you go into the mid game a lot stronger. You get your Midas quickly. You start farming quicker. You get your Radiance, and then from there you just snowball so much faster. So I mean, it's a good idea either way. Mm-hmm. I can respect that.
And you know something I noticed about Aosin's former picks? He's grabbed a lot of Wisp in the past, but we don't really ever see like a Wisp Tiny combo from Zephyr. And if there's a team that I think could really get that as a good pocket strat, I think Zephyr would be a good team to pull that off with.
Yeah, that'd be a great combo. We've seen it do so well in so many tournaments. Yeah, kind of lacking in KDL though.
Indeed. I think Phoenix has ran it like once or twice, same with Poker Face, but other than that, not really. And here's Corey, the hard carry of Zephyr. We could see him on the Wraith King this game. Yeah. It's an early pickup, but still...
Could be either a carry or a support.
We don't know yet. We really don't.
We'll have to wait and see what the third and fourth picks are to get a fair idea of what's going on.
And as far as the bans are concerned in Glade, we see Rave banning out two more heroes that Zephyr will run from time to time, both the Storm Spirit and, of course, Death Prophet, getting removed from the mix. Mid-heroes, Blitz loves to play the Storm Spirit. It is his kind of signature hero.
Absolutely.
And we have seen him on the Death Prophet a lot. Meanwhile, Zephyr, they got rid of the Treant and the Crystal Maiden. I know Rave likes CM a lot. But Treant, I don't recall really seeing them use this hero.
Well, I mean, if you're not going to pick the Treant up, it's probably a safe ban. He's he's been so strong this patch. You know, such an effective hero with living armor.
Ooh, okay. So the Morphling pickup, that hero, like the style of play, that's totally Corey style.
Yeah.
And he did pick up this hero recently, so Morphling it is once again. And this almost certainly means... we'll have this Wraith King in that support role.
That's a very good choice, I feel. I love seeing Wraith King as a support. I feel like he's one of the strongest supports just for initiating and stunning. And late game, he gets that to that semi-carry point if the game has gone well enough for him.
Yeah, that's true. He can kind of transition into a core later on. The same can be said for Naga Siren if you don't run her in a kind of carry or mid-roll. But nowadays, she's really kind of... distanced herself from the support role that we used to see her in all of the time.
Yeah, absolutely. I wonder if they're going to maybe pick up a Tidehunter with this Naga Siren. I love seeing Song of the Siren into Ravage. You know, that's an absolutely insane combination.
Yeah, Phoenix is running that, but oh, a Timbersaw pickup. All right, I'm thinking that Zephyr, they are going to do an aggressive tri-lane. They have Chilling Touch from the AA. They have the stun from Wraith King, and Morphling has a lot of DPS early on. They'll give Timbersaw a 1v1 matchup against the Centaur, and Centaur, one hero he's not that great against is the Timbersaw. So Timber can actually win his lane, and the aggressive tri-lane, if that does good, then basically Rave are going to put themselves in a very hard position. And I'm not sure if it'll be able to work. Really, though, shutting down that Naga will be very important for Zephyr, and I think almost critical to their success.
It generally seems to be the trend with the Naga pick. You really have to focus it down. You gotta shut it down early, because when it gets to late game and it's well-fed, it's so difficult to try and deal with.
I do love the Shadow Demon and Panda pickup. That's going to give them a lot more survivability from their end, as far as Rave is concerned. Panda, I'm assuming he's at the mid lane. I don't think they'll really run him anywhere else based on the heroes they've picked up.
Yeah, he'd probably have to be mid lane at this point.
They already have the Naga, which will be a safe lane with Jo. They don't really like running that hero mid too often. It's not to say that they won't, but I'm pretty sure it won't happen. And Centaur, definitely an off laner for most teams. I know there's a few Southeast Asian teams that do run Centaur in more of a position one role.
I have seen that, yeah. Yeah, I mean, it can work for sure.
I mean,
getting that kind of safe farm, getting the Link Dagger as fast as possible is a great thing to do.
The thing is, once you get six slotted on him, he's actually, like, just impossible to kill.
Yeah. Oh, he's a tanky without any items. I mean, with items, it's just next level.
You know what? This Timbersaw could actually be middle as well. I just realized that with the Tidehunter ban from Rave. But I would prefer to see it against the
Centaur, and with Doom pickup, I think it could really go either way. They could put Doom mid or Timbersaw mid. It's really Zephyr's preference. I've seen Bamboo play the Timber a little bit more, so I anticipate that'll be his hero, but Blitz has played both him.
We got an Undying.
Whoa, it looks like they want to play safe against the Trilane, but Bamboo picked up the Doom at the last second, so this will be a Timbersaw Blitz in the mid lane.
Wow, okay. This should be interesting.
Well, a very cool lineup from Zephyr. They have a lot of damage potential. They have the Doom to just shut down a single hero. On the other end, Rave, they have some pretty darn scary late game, so we'll see who ends up taking game number one here at the Korean Dota 2 League. We're about to move into game one between Rave and a Team Zephyr. My name is Whiplash. I'm casting with Moonblade. Let's move into match number two, game one.
Well, it actually says match six, set one.
Well, they're counting from the beginning of season two.
Yeah, that's hard to keep up with.
It is.
I won't hold you to that, Whiplash.
Well, thank you, Moonglade. I appreciate that. Oh, interesting. Naga's ending up in the mid lane.
Okay.
I think they realized that Naga would just not have a good time in the position one. It's Zephyr as well. They're going safe lane.
Interesting. So, not exactly what we predicted.
No, definitely not. But, I mean, again,
a lot of mind games going on right now, I think.
There's just so many different ways that both teams can kind of lane that I'm not going to, you know, kill myself if I get some of the lane predictions wrong. It's just kind of what I've noticed at a first glance and what I've seen from these teams in the past.
Yeah, I mean, these heroes are very versatile with their positioning. So, yeah, you can't really know for sure until you see it happen. But, you know, it's pretty safe choices, I think. Centaur picks up the rune.
Mm-hmm.
Bit of scouting.
And we'll see if Bamboo just starts in the jungle. He may just look for a creep to grab.
It looks like a Dagon 5.
That said, sexy, I think, Dagon.
Sexy Dagon?
Well, Bamboo is known to sometimes get Dagons.
Oh, yeah?
Indeed.
Okay.
Right, well,
safe lane Brewmaster.
Yeah. I think maybe they were anticipating an offensive tri-lane. So they're like, okay, well, Brewmaster would be a little bit more tanky and just a fair better in this role. Not as farm-dependent as the Naga.
Yeah, makes sense.
And, you know, Riptide will be nice as well against Timbersaw. A little bit of harassment back and forth between Chrissy and Eosin. They're pretty darn tanky, though, and won't fall anytime soon.
No, not at all.
But yeah, as I was saying, Moonglade, the Riptide from Naga Siren, and J.O. is still playing the hero, so no surprise there. I really think they just wanted the more favorable lane for him. Mm-hmm. But still, I think until the bottle crowing starts, Naga will really be kind of scared out of this lane, especially when level 6 comes around. And if Blitz wants to put another point in reactive armor, then a Riptide will definitely not be as useful.
Mm. Yeah, definitely a lot of damage going into that Naga in mid.
That's kind of the name of the game when it comes to Timbersaw. He's all about that extra DPS and burst.
He's brutal. He does brutal damage.
I like it. I'm curious to see how this Undying will fare later on.
Yeah, I've never really seen much of an Undying like do very well, ever, sort of thing. Like, I mean, he's kind of interesting, but I don't know. I just haven't seen him used
very effectively.
But
bottom lane, they're diving hard for Chrissy. Can they actually get a stun on them, though? Where's the Wraithfire? No, nothing quite yet. Just throwing out a few right clicks. Blitz so far doing very good in the mid lane, but last hit-wise, J.O.'s pretty much keeping up with him, 9 to 11.
Yeah, not too bad yet, but taking a lot of damage.
I love the zoning that Eosin's doing as well against Chrissy, and we're just seeing Corey get, you know, all the farm he wants. Already up to 15 last hits, and Bamboo, very low on health. He needs to be careful, man.
He's got to be real careful. He should be fine there. Some risky moves.
Bit of a risky maneuvering, and Brewmaster at least will be well on his way to a fast blink and Agdim Scepter.
I kind of like how much they're really pressuring the Centaur to get out of the lane. I mean, stopping EXP is probably the most important thing with him.
Mm-hmm.
Stopping him get to level 6 really shuts down any sort of initiation he's got early. Mm-hmm. And obviously, he's not going to be getting any gold.
Oh, whoa. Oh, okay. He died to a neutral, but I'm pretty sure that was... I think that was on purpose.
It was on purpose?
Yeah, I think so. He got his bottle, and he kind of just... He was trying to get an extra kill, but I think he realized he wouldn't get it on the creeps. So he said, okay, well, I'm really low level. I'll just buy an item, sell it at the last second so I get my money back after I revive, or just pick up the bottle.
Right, right. All right, we won't hold it against him. We'll say it was on purpose for now.
Yeah, we'll say it's on purpose, and if we're wrong, well, all I can really say
is sorry. We can't make him look bad.
No, man. As that was all according to plan.
It went all according to plan for the Doom. He was definitely skating on the edge there with his hit points. He was very, very low. No, I think it was fine.
Okay, well, so far, lanes are pretty darn even. Brewmaster, for some reason, even though the lane was completely abandoned, is like, oh, I have to get every last hit possible. But then again, it does kind of keep this lane from getting pushed out too far and makes it easier for him to farm, so I'm okay with that.
Yeah.
Mid lane, very even between the Timber as well as the Naga. And, well, I mean, bottom and top lane for both teams with their tri-lanes, they are going to win. So that's to be expected. Chrissy's really chasing Purge away. Oh, the stomp hits him, and this could actually be very bad. We'll see if he gets the... Oh, no. Oh, wow. Okay, so it's a return. And I guess Purge is okay with the trade, even if he gives the extra experience to Centaur.
I guess so. I mean...
He was going to die there no matter what.
Yeah, it was pretty safe to say.
If he like stayed in place, he could have probably ran away a little bit more, but decided to just man mode.
Yeah, and top getting pushed pretty hard by Rave, but they don't have too much pushing power, but they get the tower down pretty quickly.
Yeah, so relatively passive game so far. It is, I guess so. No, there's no heroes there.
No heroes. Just
they got me
just
excited.
Just creeping.
They got me excited and played.
Yeah, I know. Me too.
All right, but top tower will fall.
No lost hit by the Brewmaster. So
yeah,
bit
definitely.
Of a mistake there, but
he could have definitely got that.
Yeah, he's nervous. Rave is nervous right now.
No, Chrissy has picked up his Tranquil Boots and just kind of trying to sap experience where he can. He is at the level 5, which is not too bad for the offlaner.
Not too bad considering how much he's being pushed around.
And he got the experience from killing off Purge on the Ancient Apparition as well, so that's definitely something that he's got to be happy about. Mid lane, still pretty darn even between them. Wow, just neck and neck.
Very, very even game so far.
Yeah.
Except that, obviously, that tower going down up top.
Mm-hmm.
Putting Rave a little bit ahead, but not by much.
It's nice for them to have, but really it's not going to make a huge difference. I guess maybe it's nice for the Naga. She gets a little bit more gold faster. But I do want to see some rotations from Zephyr sometime soon. They don't have the strongest earlier game simply because Doom's in the jungle. And we're not seeing any rotations from Purge and the Wraith King. You can't leave Centaur alone. He's a very powerful 1v1 hero. And until your hero gets a lot of farm up, aka the Morphling, you do have to essentially babysit him for the earlier stages of the game.
Yeah, and we got a Midas online for the Morphling now, so... Farming's going pretty damn well for him, getting it around the 6 minutes 15.
Oh, mid lane, J.O. uses the song.
I don't know if he can actually make anything happen. It was kind of an escape, Song of the Siren.
Yeah, that...
TP in by the demon, but I don't know. It was kind of just wasted.
It was, and Bambo's in a bit of trouble. Chrissy, oh, he misses the stomp, and now Blitz is coming nearby. This could actually be very bad for Chrissy. He will have to eventually kind of... go near that tower. Does he have a TP on him? That's the question. I'm not sure if he does. He is just running past the tower, but Wraith Fire Blast. Is it in range? So close! Oh, just out of range. Oh, out comes. Oh, and it's enough to give the slow. And there's the Timber Chain for it. Then the death onto the Centaur. He ran across the map, tried to kill Bambo, but at the end of the day, Timber Saw and Doom, they were able to slow him. They got the stun, and they got the kill.
Yeah. Maybe a little bit of an overcommittal by the Centaur. Whiffing the stomp really sealed the deal there. He could have got the kill if he got that, but unlucky, I guess.
Still, though, I'm concerned that Naga Siren has a lot of farm she's working with. Already up to 45 last hits, as well as a one tower dead on their end, while Rave continued to push into the tier 2. Really, Zephyr, they kind of have to do something at this point.
They definitely need to start seeing more rotations, for sure. They've been very passive this game so far, and I feel like letting the Nager like get away for that long is a big mistake.
Yeah, I have to agree with you, Moonblade. Just you don't give Naga farm because looking at Zephyr's lineup, they do have some really solid late game, but it's Naga, man. She will just split push you to death, and Morphling can do good against that. If you get the Doom on the Naga, she'll still pretty much die. Mm. Generally, when Naga gets farmed up, she's just... It's so easy to just send your illusions in, go to another lane, farm, push that lane, go into the jungle. You don't necessarily need to be in the thick of the engagements.
Oh, yeah. It's a very safe way to creep and to farm up. And Sexy Bamboo, low again on HP. He's getting he's having a hard time in the jungle there. Yeah. Gotta be a little bit careful.
He's just not finding
oh, and we got a Centaur roaming through the Radiant Jungle.
Dude, we'll see if he can get a kill on somebody. As Stampede available, Bambo. Not too healthy. He's trying to get an early mech. I mean, Centaur's just moving in that jungle too much.
Yeah, he's kind of just scaring off Bambo. And I think that's a great play. I mean, waiting until his lane gets pushed up again by the...
Man, look at this.
Bottom. Oh, wow, that's a...
Oh, that is beautiful.
That's
by
a
Rave.
Lot of stacks.
Very smart by them. They have a lot of stacks. They're killing off the creeps. Jo's getting a lot of farm. The supports are getting farm as well. I feel like a few years down the road, things like this will be completely figured out, and there'll be timings where teams, they always get the stacks off, and they always get that little extra farm for their team.
And then they'll be like, the other team will know the timings also, and there'll be like big team fights over stacks in like jungles, and it's going to get ridiculous. I can see that happening for sure.
That's just a little prediction of mine. We'll see if it happens.
I like it. I think that's very true. We got a Blink Dagger online for the Brewmaster.
Well, he basically had free farm in that top lane.
Yeah, it's about time.
Yeah, it's about time. Not surprising. Just under the 10-minute mark, so pretty impressive. And looks like Rave, they want to get aggressive. They got the smoke and an invisibility room on Chrissy. It's time for Zephyr to be quite safe. And I like this because Rave, they know they've given free farm to Corey throughout the entire match. And they're looking to get him. We'll see. Uh-oh, this is bad for Corey. He is almost certainly dead. Okay, well, he goes in the strength morph, but there's just too much. Everybody piling in onto Corey. He's stuck between everything. He can't do a single damn thing. And down goes the water elemental. And we'll also see a tornado onto the Wraith Gang. Purge will fall next. And Bambo is in a lot of trouble. Same with Eos, and he doesn't have any mana for his reincarnation. They're trying to go in on Chrissy. He's doomed, low on health. And actually, somehow he did get enough mana. Eos back in the thicket of things. Here comes Blitz. We'll see if he can make something happen. Cass gets killed off, cut in half by the Chakra. So now Blitz. We'll see if he can chase anyone down. He's disrupted, but Wraith Fire Blast hits Pyong. And once again, double kill from Blitz. He's in trouble. He should be able to Timber Train away, and he does.
Definitely turned it around, but at the same time, Naga was pushing middle, and I believe they almost got the tower, if not killed it. Oh, still up, but very low. So Naga getting some free farm in while this was all happening, so not too bad at all.
Yeah, at the end of the day, it is a 2-for-1. Zephyr did lose Corey, but...
I think that's pretty important. Then they shut down the...
They have to.
Yeah.
And Zephyr now, they're angry. They're looking for that Tier 1 tower. If Naga comes, they should be able to defend it, but I think they need the Naga.
Yeah, they might just... Oh, they're kind of retreating for now.
Yeah.
Scared of that Undying, the Tombstone.
Understandable. Yeah. Like, the longer you stay around, the more annoying and hard to deal with he becomes.
Yeah, very, very true.
Well, Corey rotated towards the mid lane, the fine farm. Naga up to 76 last hits. And this is the most dangerous thing I feel for Zephyr to deal with. They can't let the Naga get her Radiance unpunished. It's 12 minutes in. She has a Ring of Aquila, 2,800 gold, well on her way to that Radiance.
Very, very well on her way. And yeah, she's been safe farming for quite an amount of time now. And they're pushing the bottom tower, bottom tier one. If they get that, it's just going to help her even more. And we've only got a rating so far coming to kind of contest this. They're going to need a lot more if they want to keep this tower safe.
Yeah, and the reincarnation's on cooldown, so it's kind of a one and done as far as he goes. But everyone else TPing in, so we're seeing what happens. And Bambo, I believe he has a Doom available. Down goes the Tombstone Ultimate from Cast, and he doesn't commit. He decides, well, he's buying so much Or I guess he's stalling for time, but in comes the Brewmaster. There's your ultimate as well. Eosin, Demonic Purge, down he falls. Toopyong, and as well, the Doom will die. This is just turning into a nightmare for Zephyr. They lost two members, and there's a song mid lane. Lots of rotations onto Blitz, and Corey, I don't know, this could end up very bad for the Zephyr combo. Oh, tying the Timber Chain, but it gets disrupted in the middle of things, taking a little bit of extra damage. And there's the Stampede to keep everybody on Rave alive. Zephyr, they back away, but they don't lose anybody. Still not what they're looking for. It's
no, a bit of an overcommittal trying to kill the Undying bottom and kind of just getting ganked.
They hesitated a lot.
They hesitated a lot, and they got into a really bad position. And now their Tier 1 bottom is getting pushed again, though it will not die, but losing a lot of hit points. Rave back off. Brewmaster's had enough.
Yes,
he's done very well.
I think he'll be picking up his point booster in a second to sell off one of those branches. Generally, you get the scepter after the blink dagger on the Brewmaster. Very common. It's not to say it's the only way to play him, but I suppose the most common way.
Standard way. And this Nogger is getting very close to a relic.
3,200, about 500 gold away.
And we got a smoke going bottom, full rave. Looking for some potential kills here.
Uh-oh, Purge could be the target. And he's hiding in the trees. We'll see if Rave just straight up go for them. They have a very offensive ward as well. And they're heading towards middle lane. Everybody from Rave is at middle, but I think Zephyr, they kind of know what's going on, and they have a smoke of their own. Uh-oh, Purge, though, he is the target. Will be put in the disruption and almost certainly dead. Throws out the Ice Blast. Actually manages to hit all of those heroes, but really won't do too much. They're moving in on the JO. His song is on cooldown. There's the Doom. And, oh, he gets stomped as well. And it's just enough DPS. Oh, tries to get the deny. They're going to move in on Chrissy next. And there's a lot of burst. It's enough. They kill off the Centaur. 2-0. Very nice moves from Zephyr. Rave, they try to kind of salvage the situation, but a bit off the mark and not as
it
smooth.
It would have been a brilliant deny, that's for sure. But yeah, they're going to lose a tier 1 for this too. At the same time, though, they are pushing the tier 1 bottom. So tower for a tower, and a Naga and a Centaur.
Eye for an eye.
Eye for an eye, kind of.
Though, it was so important for them to kill off Naga.
Yeah, that gank was long overdue, I feel.
It was.
She was so close to her relic, if not already has a relic. We'll have to have a look.
And Bloodstone picked up by the Timbersaw. So Blitz doing pretty darn good on farm. He's actually just only slightly behind Morphling, who is certainly topping the charts. The thing is, Naga, well, she basically has a relic anyway. Who cares about that death?
Oh, yeah.
Bamboo, though, he's getting netted and says, okay, well, I'm out of here.
Oh!
Oh, wow! That was really close.
Yeah. Definitely in the wrong jungle, I feel. I don't know.
You came to the wrong jungle.
Yeah.
I can just imagine like those the Donger meme. Or like the glasses, you came to the wrong Donger. Donger Jungleville place.
Indeed.
I love that meme, by the way, in the Twitch chat. It's one of my favorites.
It's a great meme.
I never get sick of the copy pasta spam. I just don't like the big like Hitler faces and stuff. I'm not really a fan of those.
No, there's some pretty crazy stuff in the Twitch channel sometimes, I got to agree.
It's entertaining at the very least, though.
Yeah, absolutely.
All right, well, Blitz, there's a lot of members charging from Rave at him, and there's a blink forward, but it's just an illusion, or I guess a replication.
Wow, they really went for it.
They definitely fell for that.
Yeah, they must feel silly.
It was just an illusion from Morphling's Replicate.
You got a blink dagger online for Doom now.
Okay, so Zephyr, they have a little bit more initiation available, and, you know, I think maybe around, like, the 25-minute mark, they'll really start to come into form. Because Morphling, he'll probably have picked up his first big item, the Lincoln Sphere, and maybe we'll have a Blink Dagger online for the Wraith King if Zephyr decide to go down that path. Doom will be strong. They'll have level 2 AA alt. Timbersaw is already basically online at this point. So that's the point where I think Zephyr will be really strong and they'll look to take some fights. That's just my prediction.
I think it's a very good prediction. I think they have to really start making things happen sooner and sooner before that Naga can really get too farmed up.
On the other side of the coin, though, Rave, during that time period over the next few minutes, they will have the Agnum Scepter on Brewmaster, and Naga will have her Radiance.
She was only, what was it, like 100 away from her Radiance last time we looked? So
I'm pretty sure it's just seconds away from completion.
Making her a whole lot stronger.
Yeah. Ooh, Blitz, he's going in for the solo kill, but in comes the waveform from Corey. They finish the job, grabs the kill.
So much damage.
But there's the Radiance.
Finally, the Radiance is online for the Nogger.
18 and a half minutes into the match, so not delayed by like a huge amount of time. And also, there was a Ring of Aquila early on. She got an insane amount of farm early on, was only killed off once, so...
Definitely not much pressure on her.
Yeah, exactly. That's definitely a good point. The lack of pressure definitely...
made it much more comfortable farming it up that much. And Lincoln Sphere, now online for the... For the Water Elemental.
Water Elemental, the Warcraft 3 name.
Yeah, I like that name.
I mean, those still for the Morphling, Lincoln Sphere. It's like his, you know, his item to get, but it's not as scary as a Radiance on Naga.
No, not at all.
So much farm.
Definitely a step in the right direction, though, for getting the Morphling online. Really farmed up.
It is kind of fun to play Naga, though, once you get your Radiance up, because you have all those illusions, and you have to kind of split them, micro them into the jungle to get that extra farm in.
Yeah, a bit of micro.
Smoke from Zephyr. They have actually four members smoked up. Aosin low on health. They're looking to grab a kill on potentially the Naga, and if they're a little bit more patient, they'll get the Panda or Naga. Oh, there's a ping, and... Does Zephyr have a ward? Blinking for it. Oh, nice counter blink. That was insane. Insane reflexes from Rior. Very impressive.
Yeah, that was really fast. That was impressive.
Smoke has been revealed. Everybody from Raves in the jungle. Zephyr decided it's smart to just hightail it out of there, and indeed they will. With Bamboo picking up a double damage rune in his bottle on the way out. That could have been very bad for Zephyr if they stuck around and lingered for a bit longer.
Oh, yeah. The counter gank was coming for sure. It could have been very bad for the Brewmaster if he didn't have, like, half a second reaction time on the blink.
Oh, he would have been dead. Yeah. He would totally been dead.
Completely. That was impressive.
I think that could have actually shifted the entire balance of the game because everyone else from Rave would have came nearby, but they would have been a member down.
Yeah, so it could have been a very, very bad fight.
Uh-oh. Yeah. Bamboo. You may not be long for this world, my friend.
He's ninjuring in the trees, but, you know, the wrong side of the tree.
Oh, okay. Well, he can't blink out of this one just as fast, and everybody piles in onto the Doombringer. He just evaporated.
Completely.
He was sent back to hell so fast.
So damn fast. And looks like they might get a tier 2 off this if the defense doesn't come in quick enough.
Well, Timbersaw is going to come in and try to defend.
And they're
going to
back off.
All right, just playing it safe.
I like that. I mean, there's no rush. As long as that Naga is continually farming, then everything is fine. They can get kills here and there and help them out. But Zephyr, quite a lead, both in experience and gold.
5,000 and 3,000 respectively. But Rave do, ironically, have a single kill advantage over Zephyr. I guess it just goes to show that Zephyr has been doing a more efficient job with their farm. Yeah. But Rave has done very well stacking creeps and providing Naga with that early Radiance.
Naga definitely pulling ahead in the kills, last hits for sure. And, I mean, I feel like it's pretty relatively really even right now. So no team really pulling ahead too far. Boots of Travel on the Naga.
Yeah, that's her next big pickup once you get the Radiance. Just allows her to farm a lot faster throughout the jungle and split push more efficiently as well. I guess she'll send her illusions around. Maybe go to a jungle with one of them or just with the main one. And Brewmaster very close to his Agnum Scepter, just about 150 gold off. Meanwhile, Shadow Demon, I mean, he's getting what he can, working on a Force Staff, I believe.
Yeah, he's getting there. Well, almost at the Force Staff.
The same actually for the Centaur, he is just lacking the recipe.
Interesting.
And I'm waiting to see what Corey plans on grabbing. I do imagine it'll be an Ethereal Blade.
Shotgun?
Yeah, that's shotgun.
I love seeing the shotgun.
Shotguns are fun. Fun for the whole family.
They can be, for sure.
Nah, just kidding. Definitely not fun for the whole family. They're fun if you're a hunter.
It's fun for the Morphling, at the very least. Oh.
Did you, in Australia, did you have the drinking phrase shotgun?
Shotguns usually used for like getting like first front seat of the car or something like.
Well, that too, but in alcoholic terms, I suppose.
Shotgun.
You take a car key and you kind of carve into the bottom of a beer can.
And you drink
and then
it.
You pop open the top and you shotgun, you one shot the beer.
No, I think that's more of an American thing.
It does seem quite American.
Yeah, very, very much American. I can't say I've seen that.
Back in the college days, that was all the rage.
Oh yeah, I can imagine. I've probably seen it in movies just like that, to do with the frat boys. And
yeah, it's definitely like a frat boying thing. I wasn't really a frat boy. I mean, I'm kind of a nerd. I love video games and such, but
you like to shotgun it. All right.
It was fun.
It's a little bit more.
A relic from the past in America, I suppose.
Yeah.
And, back into this game, we have a smoke, and Blitz could be the target. There is a Purge nearby, though, but I don't know if he can save him.
Oh, wow.
He walks into a big death trap, and even though Blitz, he's darn tanky. Look at that, man. He is insanely tanky.
Wow, I cannot believe.
29 armor and a Bloodstone and a hood. He will not fall.
He will not fall easy.
Not today.
That's insane. He had three heroes just wailing him.
Not three, man. He had four.
Four heroes just wailing him. I mean, one's an undying there.
It wasn't enough. And in comes Bambo. He gets a stomp on Pyong and a doom on, I believe, the Centaur or the Undying. And, oh, can they finish him off? Ray Fire Blast will hit. And, yeah, that should be the death for the Shadow Demon. Down he falls. So, meanwhile, Naga doing some split pushing. This is totally J.O.'s style. Whenever there's any fights happening, even if his team is losing, or especially if his team is losing.
He's not there.
He is not there, man.
He's split pushing.
In come initiation. Nice ice blast, though. It'll be enough to finish off the Centaur. And in comes the rest of Rave. We'll see if they can finish off Bambo. He's so low on health. And down he goes. Tembersaw still remaining alive. He actually kills off the Undying. And J.O., he's came into the fight, but so low. And he has the song away. Meanwhile, Bambo.
Oh, they're looking
not
for
Bambo.
Him.
Gore, he gets it. He gets the kill with the adaptive strike. They do force the reincarnation onto the Wraith King, but I mean, that ultimate brings him right back into the thick of battle. And that was a 4-for-1, excuse me. Wow.
Yeah, that was huge. That was a great fight. Tembersaw doing so well against every hero there.
I like his items because Rave, they're a team that wants to catch people out of position and just kind of burst them down. You can't burst down the Tembersaw when he has plate mail.
Yeah, he's the anti-burst right now. Like you aren't killing him with that unless you're like putting in a good amount of time.
Yeah, exactly. And there's your shotgun, Moonblade. There it is.
Finally, we get to see the shotgun on the Morphling.
So Corey is really going to start coming online at this point. A Mystic Staff is available, so that Shiva's Guard will be completed very soon for Blitz on the Tembersaw.
Oh, man. He's even going to get even more tanky after that. That's ridiculous.
Yeah, it's just a great item to have in general against Rave's team because they're going to have a lot of illusions, and slowing them down really just making them a lot less useful.
It's going to slow down a lot of damage.
The AoE will be very nice against their team as well because they have four melee members, so basically everyone will get hit by that Arctic Blast.
Yeah, the Naga's farm has been quite amazing, to say the least. Up to 232 last hits now. Doing pretty damn well, getting the farm on.
Still, we don't see an incredible amount of split push from her. Yeah, she did get the bottom tower. But beyond that, we haven't seen really too much out of her. You kind of really need to get, like, you know, 5-slotted or 4-slotted on her before you really start to see her come online. And Zephyr have actually done a pretty good job forcing team fights, applying a lot of pressure. We did see Naga was forced back in that last big engagement to the tier 2, which did end up falling anyway.
Yeah, she was just not ready for a fight like that. And yeah, she got shut down completely by the Tembersaw. Finished by the Morphling.
Yeah, exactly. All right, ladies and gentlemen, well, 27 minutes into the match, 27 and a half, it's 11-9, Zephyr with a slight edge and kills. And they are technically ahead, but still quite the even match.
Slight edge and kills and towers for sure. Definitely having the advantage, killing every tier 1 and 2.
I don't think they can push up the tier 3s too easily. That's going to be a really tough thing to do.
Yeah, and I think they know that. They might even be going for Roche right now.
Yeah, they're nearby.
Definitely hovering around it, but it doesn't look like it.
I don't think they will. That would have been very risky, but there's the next pickup for Ajayo with a...
some Manta.
Yeah, got the Manta. So extra pushing power, just a great item. More stats added to the Naga illusions.
Yeah, more illusions. More stats. Everything. Everything the Naga wants and needs.
Now still, though, the Undying only level 10 is definitely kind of behind on levels, but the same can be said.
Yeah, very lackluster support, I feel.
From both ends, actually, I want to say. We haven't seen too much from them on either end.
No, that's very, very true. Nothing too special, but I mean, Wraith King's always handy. Always great to have around just for that extra stun and some great survivability for a support. But, I mean, the Undying just hasn't done anything, to be fair.
Vitality booster on Blitz, it's either a casual vitality booster or he is just going straight into a heart. It would be a great next item for him considering he wants to really survive in these fights for as long as possible.
We have like an Aghanim's on Doom now.
Yes, we do. So basically, as long as you're chasing your opponent down, that Doom will never expire. Also using the KYX line from Free to Play. He doesn't play anymore, so I don't...
Oh, that's sad. Yeah. That's a shame.
Well, like, I think he plays casually.
Yeah. This is a fun game to play casually.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, wow. A great lead by Zephyr in both experience and gold now. Over 10,000 for both.
That's surprising, and even Morphling is ahead of the Naga net worth. I mean, Corey is really known for being able to farm extremely well and efficiently, but over a Naga Siren, that's pretty darn impressive.
Yeah, that's not easy to do. And, I mean, Timbersaur isn't even that far behind either. Great farming going on from Zephyr.
I'm pretty sure that Blitz has gotten the majority of the kills and been in most of the team fights.
Yeah, he has definitely done a lot of killing.
Yeah. Well, you know what? Hey, we're in a little bit of a break here. I believe that there could be some technical issues.
Could very well be the PC. I believe that is the PC that everyone has a problem with.
Yeah. Check out the mousepad as well.
It's
TL.
The chair. Is it the chair?
Yeah, I think it is.
Something's wrong with the chair now.
Yeah. Team Liquid mousepad, I have the same at home.
Oh, yeah? I use the SteelSeries.
I've never used a SteelSeries mousepad.
It's not a cloth one either. It's like a hard plastic one.
Yeah?
So I love it. Absolutely love it. It's the best feeling mouse I've ever had.
Oh, nice.
I used to use cloth pads back in the Warcraft 3 days.
Oh, yeah.
But, no, it's been a long time.
Okay. Looks like Blitz is A-OK, but, you know, we have a little break. Hey, man, what's your Twitter ID? I want to know it.
My Twitter ID is at MoongladeAU. You guys should follow me there.
Yeah, you guys definitely should.
Yeah, what's yours, Whiplash?
Well, it's at Whiplash, Y-A-H Whiplash. And I love Twitter followers, so if you want to go ahead and follow me, if you like the casting or just want to, you know, throw out some criticism or critiques, go for it, man. I'm all game. But speaking of games, we're back into the thick of things. Those are only illusions, Blitz, sorry. But man, they're already looking darn tanky.
Yeah, they're taking a lot of hits. Pushing the top tier 3.
This is actually very smart by Zephyr. They want to push before Naga gets too big.
No, I agree with that completely. And they're in the perfect position to do it. I mean, their items are online. All their heroes are online.
Look at Jo. He's not even with his entire team. Down goes the Tombstone, and there's your Stampede as well. Eosin low on health. And there comes the... reincarnation, everybody is slowed. Buyback from the Brewmaster, he's already dead, but Jo, he's decided, okay, I'll fight. And, Eosin low on health, I think he may go down, but being kept alive for a little bit longer, and down he will fall. So Eosin is the, I guess, second casualty. Corey being kept alive for the time being, they kill off one of the pandas. But you gotta get all three if you wanna complete the mission. And Blitz, not in the best plays. Well, he's still actually quite healthy. They do manage to take down Sexy Bamboo. So it's a 2-for-1 with a buyback and Blitz. I'm not sure where this guy wants to go.
I think he's going to...
He's buying a TP scroll.
Yeah, it looks like he's going to TP.
That's
out
actually
of here.
So funny.
It's going to be interesting to see if they can actually take him down.
Oh, that's so smart. Oh, ho! He TPs. He TPs right after the Timber Chain. It starts far away. Far enough away that the blink from the centaur can't hit him. That was so cool.
Very well played.
And he also picks up a pipe. Casual vitality booster still. I'm loving the Timber Saw we're seeing from Blitz this game.
Yeah, he's playing a great Timber Saw. I gotta say, he's been the MVP of this team so far. So far today, for sure.
Certainly. I'm a little worried. Bambo, we haven't seen a lot of action from him.
No, it hasn't been too much going on.
Doom really hasn't had an amazing game. He had a hard time in the jungle. Centaur was annoying him constantly throughout the laning phase.
I think it was very well done, too, considering how low Bambo was kind of creeping those creeps. I mean, if the Centaur came in at the right time and got a stun off, it'd kill him just about any time.
Well, at least throughout the engagement, Zephyr, they did take out the Tier 3 tower, so I think, you know, trading for the Wraith King and the Doom, it's still relatively even at the end of the day.
I think it was definitely even, and I mean, it'll definitely make it for an easier push next time.
Well, Brewmaster's picked up an Ultimate Orb, so we'll see what he wants to build, and following that could be a Lincoln. We'll see. Generally, I don't get to see too many extra items on Panda beyond the Blink and the Agnums.
Yeah.
Unless it's maybe like just a tankier item. So up in the air what that could end up being.
So we're going to see Jeyu actually be more present at this fight instead of coming in halfway through, which I think would be a lot more important. Doing a split push at the same time with Mirror Image.
Okay. All right, there's the song Zephyr. They have everybody hooked up together. Panda will be in the middle of things, and this could turn up to be a disaster for Zephyr. We'll see exactly what happens. Aosin low on health. 3 seconds he needs to survive. No, not long enough to use his ultimate, but we see on the back end, Centaur has fallen, and look at that, Blitz and Corey. They are just going through this entire squadron, bursting down members. The Doom is on Jeyu, he's forced back into the well. Bambo low on health, but still alive for the time being. There's a lot of zombies angry at him. And we'll see, looks like Panda, his ultimate is warned off. Corey, is he going to take out any of the towers? It's a 2v, or it's a 3v4 situation. And this is kind of awkward, man. Blade.
It's kind of strange, but I don't know if they want to stay or not. I mean, they're really indifferent right now. They can't really make up their mind.
Yeah, and okay, well, they back off. They say, let's just play it safe. We got a few kills, but we don't have Doom, and Naga's still alive, so they back off. Yeah, that felt a little bit odd.
That was a little bit awkward. I mean, yeah, they didn't know what to do at that point, and then I think backing off was definitely the better idea.
Okay.
They could have done it a lot earlier, and they probably could have gone for more of a creeped a little earlier, started farming again, maybe going for Roshan or anything.
All right, well, Lincoln's Sphere will be the next pickup for the Siren, and this will give her, you know, more stats, and it'll pretty much prevent Zephyr from just throwing the Doom on her.
Yeah.
They need to activate the Lincoln Sphere or knock it off before.
Oh, wait, they go ahead. Bamboo might be out of position. Oh, no.
He's tanky, but Centaur's nearby. I don't know. He blinks away. So Bambo's safe.
He's safe.
He's A-okay. And a pipe will be finished momentarily for the Centaur. Still, nobody has decided to contest Roshan quite yet. Sending in an illusion just to kind of check him out. Well, even the Timbersaw kind of throwing a chakram in there.
Both teams kind of just rotating around jungle, rotating the middle. Kind of decide what the next step should be. And, kind of playing very defensive right now. But man, 359 lost hits on that Naga now. She's still getting great farm in with the mirror images.
Yeah, honestly, I think that the only reason why Zephyr haven't taken down the Tier 3 barracks or don't have a larger lead in this game is because they let the Naga Siren go through the draft and they gave it to Rave. It's a hero that Jeyu loves to play and will almost always pick up if he can.
And we can see exactly why. He's doing so well with the split pushing.
Yeah, it's just a hard hero to deal with. Those illusions only get stronger. We'll probably see there's still 2 slots left on the Naga. So we could see a butterfly or maybe a defusal blade, a heart. There's a lot of different available items for the Naga to really pick up.
I'd definitely like to see a butterfly next. Me, personally, I'm a big fan of the butterfly.
Butterfly is good. I'd be okay with a heart. Manta, or not Manta. Okay, hold on a second. We have the song, but the pipe's already up. So a lot of the spell damage will be negated. Pipe on both ends. And man, just in the thick of things, Bambo, they're trying to burst him down, but he's still managing to stay alive for a little bit longer. Now just doing his best to escape. And oh, he's just so low. Can they actually get him though? No! Bambo with 44 health survives. They move in on the Pion. They get the kill there. 3 members already dead on Rave. They're going after Jeyu. They get him. Instant buyback from the Naga. And there's the glyph as well. But Zephyr, they have everybody up. They have no ultimates from Rave. What can they do besides delay? Nothing.
Absolutely.
They're going to lose
nothing.
The Tier 3 Moonglade.
They lost the Tier 3. They lost the barracks.
And the battle.
They lost everything right there.
Well, this is terrible for Rave. Zephyr, if they get a second pair of racks, I think this may just be...
This could be game very well
yes,
right here. I mean,
this could be game.
They still have... They've had no answer at all for Blitz this game at all. He's just...
Jeho, no! Oh. Caught and by every spell imaginable. The buyback essentially useless.
That was definitely a dieback.
I think as well... This means Zephyr can move into the third set of racks, and with that, the game will see if they want to go for it.
I think they should at this point. Absolutely. I mean, without Nagar, there's absolutely no hope of stopping this at all.
They're going for it, and Corey's so farmed. Oh, it's 4v5, but I feel like Zephyr can take this. They're kind of moving back and forth.
They're kind of positioning so to avoid any sort of like blinking shenanigans.
Still reincarnation for the Wraith King.
I guess they'll play it safer.
Ooh, okay.
We got a heart on Timbersaw now, so even more tankier. He doesn't even need to be more tankier because he just doesn't die at the moment. This is nothing to stop him.
Almost 3k health.
And they're just going for Roche, and I think this is the next best idea to actually ending the game.
Mm-hmm. Well, hold on a second. It looks like Corey, he soloed off Byung. Now they're moving back into the pit. And yeah, it was like really even between the teams. And then Zephyr, they had one good engagement up top, and then they got the second one, which allowed them to get two lanes of barracks and a tier 3 tower. Morphling's picked up his butterfly. It's all but over for Rave.
Yeah, it's just a matter of time now. There's really nothing they can do. They've just shown it time and time again they can't win these team fights at all. No matter how good the positioning is they get with the Song of the Siren, I mean, it just doesn't matter. They don't do enough damage. They can't stop Blitz. They can't stop the Timbersaw at all. They can't stop the Morphling at all. There's just no damage besides the Nagar. She's good at split pushing, but she's not enough.
Here's the problem. Like you said, Moonglade, there's just not a lot of damage. Undying really just kind of tapers off at the later stages.
I feel like it was a mistake picking up Undying. I have
a feeling that they were really anticipating a tri-lane versus tri-lane scenario and wanted to shut it down.
I guess
using
that hero. Yeah, that would be a very useful hero that early, but yeah. When it gets to this stage of the game, just useless. Just free money from the tombstone at this point.
And even the panda as well really kind of falls off after the mid-game stages. He's so powerful when you get that Aghanim Scepter, but we're in the later stages where you kill off the Wraith King. Who cares? Timbersaw will not die to that panda. Ancient Apparition's going to be way back and not on the front lines of team fights. You know, Morphling has various ways to kind of escape death, as well as just dish out some serious DPS, and Doom's quite tanky himself.
And a refresher orb on the Doom.
Oh, man. This is...
Oh, my goodness.
This is basically like I am shutting you down one way or another.
Yeah. Oh, that's brutal. Yeah, these guys are so stacked right now. It's just a matter of time until they push up that bottom lane, get Mega Creeps, and...
Even Aghanim's Scepter on the Ancient Apparition.
Yep. These guys are loaded.
Meanwhile, Naga has... not the best items, and she's actually out of position. She can teleport away, but will be in time. They do not have a glyph, and down goes one tower. And the second one will follow up shortly. Everybody from Eye of the Tiger, they can't even defend the Tier 3. They're waiting for the Naga, and look at that! The shotgun, adaptive strike, and waveform into a dead undying. Sexy Bambo in the thick of things, but they already kill off the Brewmaster. He buys back instantly. It's basically the final stand from Rave, but everybody from Zephyr, they're piling inside the well.
Oh my
god.
Look
at Blitz, he doesn't care, man. He's in the thick of things. Look at how tanky he is. GG is called. That's the game. Zephyr with a dominating match one performance. Very well executed. Wonderful team fights. Not even the Naga Siren could stop them, Moonglade.
Not at all. I mean, it was looking very even for the early game. Going into the mid game, they were looking even, but their heroes, as you were saying, tapered off a lot. The Brewmaster got to the late game and was pretty much useless.
Yeah.
The Undying was completely useless after the early game, but even early game, he didn't really do that much because it wasn't a tri-lane versus tri-lane.
So ironically, with the Naga, we just could not see Rave.